scary character.
I am a wizard. Some may call me a dark mage.
So,
which name I really like. How am I so skinny?
Oh, good morning to you. How you doing? What are you doing with that book right there? Hello. That's like a tablet, ain't it? Don't be doing that. Don't be watching movies in church. What's wrong with you? Amen. How y'all doing today? Pretty good? Pretty good. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hey, sweetie. It's good to see you back. Amen. You're having them young ones, you can't always go like you want. I'm glad you can watch online, though, right? That's a blessing, ain't it? Praise the Lord, Jessica. Good to see you, girl. I'm glad you're here today. Amen. Let's get up on our feet, guys. Get up on your feet. Amen. Amen. Well, it certainly ain't January around here, is it? It's not wall-to-wall people. I get that. But I'm going to tell you something right now. We had a great crowd in the first service. This is a good crowd right here. Amen. Say, we in church, baby. Amen. We're going to have us a good time. You're going to be blessed today. I'm going to tell you that right now. It's going to be fantastic. Amen. Looking forward to it. All righty. I'm just trying to get everybody in. Come on. If you outside, quit talking to them at the door. Come on in. Holding us up. Amen. You're going to have a real treat today. The old song, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. It's an old song. But Joel and Mitch and Chris took it and made it new, made it fresh. So you're going to have a fellowship original today, amen? Pretty exciting about that. Good music today. Fantastic, amen? Are y'all ready? Elise, you're dancing around. What's wrong with you? Come on. Come on, let's put our hands together. Thank God we live in America. Come on, here we go. Woo! Amen! Come on! Here we go! Sing with us, this song is called Open Up the Heavens. Sing with us, here we go. Praise the Lord, amen.
We've waited for this day, we're gathered in your name, oh, calling out to you. Your glory like a fire, awakening desire, will burn our hearts with truth. You're the reason we're here. You're the reason we're singing. Open up the heavens, we want to see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. Your presence in this place, your glory on our face, so we're looking to the sky. Descending like a cloud, you're standing with us now. Oh Lord, unveil our eyes, 'cause you're the reason we're here. You're the reason we're singing. So open up the heavens, we wanna see you. Open up the floodgates, river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. So open up the heavens, show us your glory, Lord. So, show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory, Lord.
One more time.
Show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your glory, Lord. Open up the heavens, we wanna see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. So open up the heavens, we wanna see you. Open up the floodgates, a mighty river flowing from your heart, filling every part of our praise. We've waited for this day, we're gathered in your name, oh, calling out to you.
It's the Lord's Day, Sunday morning, amen. What a great song to set the table for us this morning. That's why we're here. We've waited for this day. This is a good, man, it's the first day of the week. People don't know that. A lot of people think this is the last day of the week. Monday's the first day, got to go back to work. Honoring the Lord comes before your work. This is the day the Lord's made. This is the day we honor the Lord. We put Him first. I'm going to tell you right now, you want to better fight the devil? Better fight his tail? Come on. You tell him, I started my week with Jesus. When he gets about Wednesday, you tell him that. You tell him that. I started my week with the Lord. I might not have my act totally together, but I know one thing. I got my tail out of bed. Now I was at church on Sunday morning. You know, so get out of my house. Amen. Come on. You hear me? Praise the Lord. Another great song. Another great song on the heels of that one. Open up the heavens, Lord. We want to see you. Let's sing a song that's become a favorite around here over the last 10 years or so. It's called How Great is Our God. If you don't know it, you'll learn it. If you know it, man, let her rip. Let her rip. We're not ashamed. Why would I be? Come on. Well, I don't sing that good. You'll be fine. Blend it all together with all of us. You sound like a champion. Come on. Here we go. Come on. Here we go. Come on. Let's sing it. Here we go.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great, how great is our God. The end. The Godhead three in one. Oh, Father, Spirit, Son, the Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God. Oh, how great is our God. Oh, sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God. You know the name above all names, and He is worthy of all praise. My heart will sing, how great is our God. Oh, you know the name above all names, and He is worthy. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, see how great is our God.
Sing it again. Come on, sing it for the Lord this morning. Come on, tell it.
How great is our God. Our God, oh, see how great is our God.
God, I know I'm wearing you out, but we're going to do it again. Here we go. How great, come on,
is our God.
Come on.
Sing with me, how great is our God. And oh, see.
Make some noise. Thank the Lord. He gets all the credit. Amen. Praise the Lord, man. It's good. Now, this is my second service, but I preach two different messages so I don't get bored. Amen. Two different titles, two different subjects. But I tell you what, the music was what we had in the first service. And what I do in the second service, I just know what I had in the first service, and I get excited because we're fixing to do it again. You know, some songs you just want to hear again sometimes on the radio. Man, I wish they'd play that again. That's what I get here on Sunday morning. I get to do it twice. Amen. I love to sing for the Lord. Amen. And I love you singing with me. And here I grew up, Hellraiser, never sang. Are you kidding me? And I went to church after I became a Christian. There were some pretty girls hanging out at the piano one night, so I thought I'd hang out with them. About 17 years old. And they started singing, and they said, can you sing? And I'm like, man, sissy, sing. I play ball, that's what I do. I'm all that. But they were really pretty, so I started to sing. Amen, I've been singing ever since, amen. Matter of fact, I formed a quartet with those pretty girls, and we used to travel around North Carolina, amen. Praise the Lord. I didn't know big old fellas could sing to the Lord. I think God loves it when He hears us sing. You hear me today? Let's do it one more time. How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God? And all will see how great is our God. Father, we love you. We fall at your feet. You're God. We're not. You're our Savior and our Lord. Jesus, we believe in you. We don't believe that we're good enough to get to you. No, Lord. We believe you loved us so much that you gave your life for us. Your creation, you came and died for us and rose for us so that we could be with you and have relationship with you. Lord, we believe that. That's who we are. We're your children. Lord, you know we still got issues and problems and struggles. But Lord, thank you. You're the friend that sticks closer than a brother. You never leave us nor forsake us. Lord, when we ask forgiveness, Lord, you're the best daddy in the whole wide world. You freely forgive, and you wash it away as far as the east is from the west. You don't throw us out with the trash. Thank you, Lord, for loving us like that. We fall at your feet, and we cry out, how great, how great, how great, how great is our God. The pit you found us in, that you dug us out of, oh God, you're a great God. We fall at your feet today. We love you. Lord, we love you because you love us. We don't love you because we just great, Lord. No, you great. And we love you because you great. So, Lord, thank you for that. Give us an awesome day. Lord, I pray for this service that it'll be just like the one before. Oh, God, you showed up. You helped us. You blessed us. You encouraged us. Lord, we want a double blessing. I want to be blessed again, Lord. I want this service to be is greater than the first one, Lord. I pray for that. Oh, God, give us a great morning. We love you. We're going to give you all the credit in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord, guys. Be seated if you would. Yeah, man, my back's feeling about this much better. Not much, but I will take that much. Amen. Come on. So I'm feeling better. Thank you for your prayers. Amen. It's going to be a climb, but we'll get there. Miss Rachel, how you doing?
Great.
You sporting that blast shirt. Forget about it. Amen.
I love it.
Come on.
Makes getting dressed for church easy. Just throw a blast shirt on. Well, it is. Well, good morning again and welcome to Fellowship Church. We're so excited that you're here with us today. If this is your first time joining us, we want to thank you for joining us and for choosing Fellowship Church to worship. And we'd like to give you a gift just for coming today. So please see the table just outside the doors. Someone there will greet you and welcome you and give you that gift just for coming today. We appreciate that. And we also ask that you fill out the guest registry and your worship guide. Let us know how you found us here at Fellowship Church, or maybe you have a question about baptism, or you want to become a member, or just any question that you have on there, you can throw on there with your information, and we will get those questions answered to you. So please take the time to do that, and again, welcome. Our first Sunday communion is today. We had a great communion after the first service, or right after this service. We're going to meet right out by the crosses. I don't think the rain is going to hit us, so we'll be able to go out there and have a wonderful communion on the first Sunday of the month. And tonight is our blast meeting right here at the church. This is our middle school ministry for grades 6, 7th, and 8th, and we're going to be meeting from 5 to 7. This is all free for you, dinner, and we're getting to the Word, and we play some games. And today we're going to do something special for our moms, I think, so come on out. Doors will open at 4:30, so please, if you want to come and just hang out and play and just fellowship with each other, get to know one another. And if you haven't tried us out yet and you are in middle school and you're wondering what Blast is all about, well, you got to come and find out. So please join us tonight at Blast. And thank you so, 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 so much. I saw buckets full of cookies out there. If you weren't here last week and didn't hear the announcement, Mama Heeg is asking for cookies. She's going to be taking cookies and invitations and flyers into the middle schools to give to the middle school, because our theory is if we bring cookies into the middle school, then Mama Jordan won't have to bring them into the prisons later in life. So, and I think she heard that last week. She was watching, and I think Dory told me that she heard it last week, and she was like, what's that all about? So yeah, we're pretty excited about that. So, we needed 700. I don't know if we got that or not today. I'm pretty sure we might be close to it, but if you didn't get a chance to give today, we will be collecting them throughout the week. You can drop them off at the church office. And yay, thank you. And Chips Ahoy or BOGO this week, so grab yourself a couple boxes of those. One for yourself and one for us, whichever. We have our brand new 20-ounce Arctic tumblers. They're on sale for $10. We had about 15 to 20 left first service, so I don't know if there's any left out there. So if you haven't gotten yours, please get yours. And if they run out, I'm sure there'll be more coming. So get our sign right out there into the community. And people will ask, and you can tell them. We have a new men's community Bible study on 7 p.m. On Tuesdays right here at the church, talking about and studying the book of Genesis. So guys, come on out and join that study. What else? Oh, and don't forget, one of my favorite days of the year is Mother's Day. Is next Sunday, so we're going to have a special gift for our moms. So invite your mom to join you if you can, if she's able. And come on out and let's celebrate moms next Sunday.
Most of y'all that know me know how much I love my mother and the death of my mother. She was murdered. It killed me, okay? But I tell you what, she's in heaven today. She's having church with us today. Mama's saying that's good down there, amen? But we got a special gift for you ladies next weekend. And I'm not going to tell you what it is, but Dina, you liked it. And Dina's a mama, okay? And of course, we're going to give them to everybody, so it ain't super expensive, but it's nice and it sort of has a connection. I'm not going to tell you, but back to my mother. Amen? You'll see it, and we want to give it to you next week. Anybody coming, bring somebody. Let us love on some ladies next week that would maybe come, and we could just love on them. Can we do that next week? Praise the Lord. Come on.
And just for moms, next week is also our YFF, which is our Young Family Fellowship that we have once a month at Rotunda Park. And this is a great time for our families to come and get together. Dinners, it's just around Parade Circle here, right up the road.
And that time probably is different too, isn't it? Probably 4:30 to 6:30.
Is it 5? Actually, I think they changed it to 4:30. But whatever, we'll get the time right next week. But moms, if you come, you're going to get your car washed by your kids, and maybe your husbands will get out there and help the kids while we sit back and relax and watch them clean our cars. So come on out to YFF next week and get your car washed by the kids and the dads. Wouldn't that be fun? Yes. So come on out and just let's have a good time. The moms can sit and just, enjoy watching and not cooking, because dinner will be there for you. Senior Fellowship Luncheon is Thursday, May 17th at 11 a.m. right here in our lobby. We ask that you do sign up for this and that you plan to bring a side dish or dessert to go with the meal. It's a great time. And we also have, ladies, a Women's Spring Luncheon. This is our month. I like this. Yeah. Women's Spring Luncheon, Saturday, May 19th at noon right here at our worship center. We do ask that you sign up and get a ticket. It is a free event, but you do need a ticket, because when you show up, we're going to take that ticket, tear it in half, and you're going to get a chance to win some prizes. So you may want to make sure that you get your ticket today. I got mine, and I'm excited. Hopefully baseball's over by then, and I'll be able to join all of you ladies. So Women's Spring Luncheon, please get your ticket in the lobby today. This wasn't in the first service. So May is a huge month. Yeah, so May 27th is our Freedom Celebration Sunday. We're going to have some great services at both the 8:30 and the 10:30. And then after the 10:30 service, we're going to have a barbecue. So right here on our property, right at the picnic table. So join us for that on the 27th. I hope you all have a wonderful day and a blessed week. Thank you.
Look at May, man. Come on. I have people that are from up north, snowbirds, and we still got some of you guys that are hanging out. We don't call you snowbirds if you stay later. Amen? No. We don't say that. You're here a lot longer. We appreciate you. But anyway, a lot of them think, what do we do when they're not here with us? We have great times. We have church. Amen? And a lot of times in the summer, we're able to reach out to local people and we can see some growth. It's not full house like it is in the winter, but we see some growth every summer. Amen? And so we're excited about it. So May's going to be an exciting month. Today at Fellowship Church, I love the fact that our team here, especially Miss Karen, Mitch, and now that's sort of spreading, I think, to all of us, we have a great love for hymns and their richness. Of course, we love all kinds of music. We love contemporary, some that get up and go, but we love songs with heart and with feeling. This is one of those old hymns that Joel has taken with Mitch, and pretty much Joel's creation. This is Joel's creation. He put it together,
And it's a very special song. It's called Come Thou Fount. How many know the old song, Come Thou Fount? Remember that song? Amen. Well, here's a brand new version. I believe it's good enough to play right on the radio today. You're fixing to hear it. It's this good. And I'm proud of you, son. And I'm proud of you guys. It features especially the boys. I think Rod's over there on the bass as well. Amen. But Chris is going to be back on those drums with some pretty cool riffs. You're going to get there. You're going to really enjoy it this morning. Let's welcome the boys and thank the Lord for Joel writing this and putting it together. A Fellowship original right here. Come on.
Come thou fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, calls for songs of loudest praise. Teach me songs. Seal it for thy court
great. Great song, right? Praise the Lord. Let's get on our feet. Miss Karen, how'd you like Miss Karen? Miss Karen, Miss Karen, I'm talking to you. How'd you like that? Isn't that good? Isn't that good right there? Isn't that good? Ain't that good? Some of you that like them old hymns, wasn't that good? Say, wasn't that good? Wasn't that good to hear young men singing that for the Lord? Amen. I love that. Radio quality right there, baby. I'm telling you, that's a good song.
No one listens to the radio anymore, Dad.
I listen to the radio. How many listen to the radio? Amen. You're in radio land down here, son. Amen. I guess you can tell we're old if we still listen to the radio, right? Come on. Count me in then, baby. Amen. Hey, praise the Lord. Thank you. And we're gonna go ahead and go with our next song. I'll talk about the offering in just a bit, but let's go ahead and if you're able to get up with us on your feet, if you need to stay seated, that's okay. But let's sing a special, special song called Here's My Heart. If you don't know it, you'll learn it quick and you'll love it. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Made pure, I have heart,
my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. And here's my life, Lord. Here's my life, Lord. Here's my
Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? That is one of my favorite songs. I love it because it's things you can just say to yourself. And we're, if you're anything like me, you're just so hard-headed. And we need to tell ourselves, I am loved. I'm pure because of your forgiveness. I am free. You're strong. You're more than enough. That song just, it overwhelms me, doesn't it, you? It's like a bus running over you. I love that. Go ahead, hit me with that, amen? Come on. That'll change you. Good stuff. Boy, I love just getting to worship here. Amen? Good stuff. Thank you for giving to the Lord's work. Now, last week, all the offering went to the Terrace Project. So give you a quick update. Last week, probably it came out to be about $17,000+ went toward that project. So we're about 50, so that put us about 33 away. That's about where we're at. Amen. Come on. Debt-free is a good thing. You hear me? Debt-free is a great thing. Have you ever tried to do something debt-free and then you really buckled down and you found money that you didn't know you had? You might have had to sell something, but you turned it into money, which helped you accomplish that goal. How many would say that's happened in my life? For sure. You sort of start buckling down, you find things you didn't know you had. Yes or no? Well, I've been on this journey a while, this debt-free journey at the Fellowship Church. Amen. Everything you don't know how many times I tell people, that seat you leaning on, this carpet you walking on. By the way, this week, look at these speakers. You see these speakers? How many would say down front you heard better this morning? Tell me if you did. Didn't you hear a lot better down? Guess what? Because there's six. Is there six? There's eight. Eight brand new digital speakers that go along with what we did here. This is all part of us doing that. It's all a part of a plan here to make this room like it's supposed to be. Amen? So we went ahead this week and was able to do that. Even though we can't jump out and do that right now, we did this week. Amen. Can we thank the Lord for that? Debt-free. Debt-free. Amen. And it blessed us already, didn't it? Amen? So, anyway, so somebody came to see me this week. Yeah. And want to know how much was needed so that we could do that thing there debt-free. I said, well, probably about $33,000. And they said, well, we want to make sure that that happens. We'll take care of that. Amen. Come on. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on. Come on. And they know me. We won't take anything, but what's beautiful is that people don't want no credit. They want God to get all the credit. How many have been with us on this fellowship journey for at least probably 10 years? Let me see your hand, at least 10 years. So me telling you that, it's nothing new, is it, guys? To see the Lord do for us. Amen. Yes or no? You just never know, man. When you do something debt-free, you don't know the blessing that is in front of you. I encourage you to try to do that at your house as well. You listen to me. It's a good thing, but what a church that we can do this and God gets all the credit. Amen. So one other update. I told you we probably won't be able to do that terrace this summer. It's not like it's the end of the world. We got seats and they work. Amen. Say. But we don't want to get in a bad situation with our crowd coming back. There's no, where would we put them? We'd have no, if we don't have it there and it's construction's on, we're shot. What are we going to set on top of each other? Well, the builder, if you're watching, I love you, Alan. He called me and said he's going to do what he can to get down there to the county this week, put a timeline, and he'll present it to me and to Alex, our administrator. And if we firmly believe it can get done, we'll go forward. If we don't believe it can get done, we're going to wait. Amen? Say. But the bottom line, we can't be playing games here. Yes or no? Amen. Because God's been good to us. Amen. But it's not like we don't have the funding to let's get it done and move quick. Let's go. Amen. But the building business is crazy busy right now. We can't expect people to do, that's a small commercial project compared to these big projects they have. Amen? Let's keep that in mind. But anyway, so we're not totally, that ain't totally off the table yet. Amen? So just pray about it. Pray about it. Amen? How about that? Isn't this fun? Is this fun or what? It's fun doing this at church. How many of you have gone through building stuff at other churches that like killed you? Let me see your hand. I mean, oh my God, I like it's the worst thing on the planet. That ain't the fellowship, is it? Yes or no? We have fun, don't we? And we get there when we get there, hallelujah. Amen. And God gets all the what? Amen. If you don't believe it, there's a sign out front that says it. Amen. Come on, come on. Go look at that sign and touch it and say, that's you, God. You get all the credit. Amen. Come on. Whoo, I got to quit. I'm getting excited. Thank you for giving today. Today's offering, and by the way, from here on out through the fall, we won't be setting aside any other offerings because a wise person takes and plans. And we know that during the summertime, we don't have the funds that we have during the wintertime. Yes or no? Amen. So from here on out, boy, know that your gift really matters. Amen. To help us make take care of our bills and maintain our campus and everything. But if you can't do it cheerfully, we ask you to what? Hang on to it. Praise the Lord. Dale, come pray for us, buddy. Thank you, buddy. Love you and your family. Amen. Love you back, buddy. We're going to give some credit because the Lord blessed you with a what just recently?
Brand new house. Just got moved in last week.
They've been building it, right?
14 months.
14 months. Moved from Indiana down here to be with some family, but also to move down here to be with us. They loved our church, and they loved our families. Amen? And so God, he was patient, stayed in a what, an apartment or something?
Stayed in an apartment in Indianapolis for 3 months, then one here for 10 months, and then with my mother-in-law
That's rough. You're out of there, amen. Come on, pray for us, buddy. Praise the Lord, amen. Come on.
Thank you, Lord, for this awesome, amazing day. Thank you that we live in America,
a great country.
And that we have the opportunity to worship here freely. There are many places that don't get the opportunity.
Absolutely.
We bless the giver today as
Amen.
They give their gifts.
Help
and bless
Lord.
The gift and let it double and triple to meet the needs of this church. Please be with Gary as he recovers through his back his back issues and anybody else that's working through health challenges.
Help them.
Let us not forget the biggest offering of all that you gave your son Jesus for us.
Jesus.
In your name we say these prayers. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, buddy boy. Love you, man. Proud of you and your family. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Thank you, guys. You're a blessing. Thank the Lord for everybody that served us today. I'm talking to Larry back there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Here we go. I'm back there talking to Larry and Chris behind the curtain and Elise. Y'all don't know what goes on back there. But I get a chance to love on them and tell them how much we love them and appreciate them. Amen. So good stuff. Let's go to the Word this morning. Amen. Woo! Here we go. Boy, I've had a good time with this little series. Don't you want to be smart? Come on. I mean, you say, I don't like church. But yeah, but don't you want to be smart? You think anybody would like this, right? Say, except the dumb person. Amen. So that's the title of it. Just a simple little title. Don't you want to be smart? I just sort of like the way it sounds. Don't you want to be smart? All right, here we go. Let's go with the message this morning. We've had about three of these so far. Let's add another one to it. Here's one. Here's one. You want to be smart? Say that with me. Like what God likes. You want to be smart? Say it one more. You want to be smart? Then say that with me. I don't like what God likes. I'm sorry. You're dumb. It's not going to work out well for you. I'm going to tell you that right now. So let's go to the message and to the Word this morning. Like what God likes. You want to be smart? You want to be smart? You want to be smart? Then understand what really matters to God. And this is not, these are cookies on the bottom shelf. This isn't going to be so hard. Oh, I can't be smart because it's above my head. I try not to preach above our head, because if it's above our head, then it's above my head. I come to church for me, too. I come to church. I'm up on this stage so many times, and I'll say things I never even intended or that I didn't even see. You know? But I try to be studied and planned and, you know, sort of know what we're doing. But the bottom line is I want the Lord to teach me today. I want to be smarter today than I was yesterday. Help me, Lord. Amen. So let's learn together what really matters to God. What is it? Here it is. And I put them together for us based on some scripture that I'm going to give you. And Raj and I have worked together on a chart, and you're going to see it as all unfold before your eyes today. Amen. So here we go. Here's what really matters to God. My attitude, my words, my touch, my thoughts, my walk, my actions, and my heart. Now, I want you to say that with me. Roger, let's start again at the top. Let's get him to say it with us, buddy. Here we go. Here's what really matters to God, because the church is crazy, and we're crazy. We think, well, I give money to God, so God really loved me. Was that on the list? Say, well, I do good works, and I'm a good work, and I, you know, is that on the list? Yes or no? I have this education, and look at me, I'm special. Yeah, amen? Say, I'm good looking, look how good looking I am. Look at this. Is that on the list or not? Say. Now, listen, if you got all some of that, good. It just didn't make the list. I'm not saying it's bad. It just didn't make the list. So, let's go with the list. And you say, well, Clark, where'd you come up with the list? Well, I came up with it on the Word. You're going to see it in just a bit. But let's just go over it with me. Help me now. What really matters to God? Can we do it pretty loud? Are y'all awake with me or not? Do I need to jump up and down or anything? Say. Here we go. What really matters to God? Say it with me. My attitude, my words, my touch, my thoughts, my walk, my actions, and my boom. Now, so far, we're getting smarter. Y'all hear me? We found out now what really matters to God. Now, these are what to God? Big deals. It's not that other things don't matter to God. But some things are really big, honking deals. And this is the day. This is it. Amen? This is big stuff. Amen? Big stuff. So that's the message today, what God likes. Now, we sort of laid a little bit of the groundwork, but now we're going to go in. Now, we're going to start digging. We're going to find today. Let's see what we can find. Here we go. So let's break them down. My attitude, my attitude, my attitude. We're going to go to Proverbs chapter 6. Proverbs chapter 6. This series has come from where? What book? The book of what? Proverbs. There's 31 chapters in the book of Proverbs. I guarantee it, no holds barred, absolute money-back guarantee, if you will start, what's today's date? 6th of May. You read Proverbs chapter 6 today, Proverbs 7 tomorrow, Proverbs 8 the next day, and never, ever, ever, ever miss another day of reading the Proverbs, one proverb a day from the Word of God. I guarantee it. You, my friend, can mark on a calendar the day that you started getting smarter. The day you started getting smarter is the day that I took these Proverbs, a book of wisdom found in the Word of God, and I started reading them every day, clockwork, with my calendar on my wall. And the days that have 30 days in the month, well, I read 30 and 31 that day because I got a brain and I can do two of them. Amen. Say. But for the most part, it works like clockwork. It's beautiful. So that's what we're doing. We want to learn how to be smart. We're going to the book of Proverbs. That's where we've been. Now, today there's a chapter. When you read through the book of Proverbs, there's certain chapters. Boy, chapter 7 talks about the ways of a strange woman. A woman that will tempt you and lure you. You could put man right in there. A man that will tempt you and lure you. There's a whole chapter on that. Did you know that? Some of you, I didn't know it was in the Bible. Yeah, it's in the Bible. You should have read it, fool. You hear me? But before chapter 7 is chapter 6. And it's a powerful thing. It hits you right upside the head just like a baseball bat. And here it is. So number one, we're going to look at verse number 6, and I'm going to take one word at a time, or a couple of words at a time, so that I don't overload our brain. So, and I'm the one that has put the words on the right, these words up top now. I've connected them to the verse. Got it? So let's say that first part of Proverbs chapter 6. These are things, what does the Lord like? Well, He really likes us to have a good attitude. But actually, what this actually says in Proverbs 6, it says these are six things that God hates. These are six things that God hates, and seven are an abomination. So I can learn what God likes by knowing what God what? Hates. That ain't that hard, is it? Say. So here's what God hates. And it strikes at our attitude. Here it is. Say those three words with me. A proud look. A proud look. A proud look. So God hates that. God hates pride in my attitude. Oh, I understand. He understands my pride. He don't understand it. He don't like it. It's evil to Him. He will never, ever, 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 ever exalt you. You will be the one who's manipulated and massaged a situation or connived or whatever to get you where you're getting. And it sure won't Him. Because He ain't playing that mess. He is all against pride. Y'all hear me or not? When God says He hates something, man, that is something big. Amen. So He hates pride. So my attitude, help me, buddy. Smartness is this, and I put it in plain English. So my attitude, I need to be what? I need to have humility, and I need to be what? Selfless. Say that with me. I need to be what? Selfless. So smartness is humility, and it's me being selfless, not full of myself, but less of myself. What is dumbness? Because I thought we'll make it plain English for us. Smartness, dumbness. Here it is. Dumbness is what? It's what? Pride, and it is being what? Self-full, or full of myself. Don't you want to be smart? Here's how, are we doing okay or not? Or am I boring you to tears already? Good. Here we go. See the nice little chart? Here we go. So here's smartness, humility. That's me being selfless. Here's dumbness, pride. That's me being full of myself. Proverbs 6:15, everyone that's proud in heart is an abomination to the Lord. Anytime you see abomination next to a sin, that's bad. Though hand join in hand, the proud, he shall not be what? Unpunished. Let's keep looking. Push me. He that is of a proud heart stirs up what? You don't generally see these people that are full of themselves being the best peacemakers. Oh, let me humble myself and help you. No, that ain't generally what they do. They stir up strife. But he that puts his trust in what? The Lord shall be made what? One of my favorite verses in the Bible. That's why I'm heavy. Amen. Come on. It just means you put your trust in the Lord, you're going to be blessed. You be selfless, you be humble, the Lord's going to lift you up. That's what the Bible teaches. Talking about attitude. Only by pride comes what? Very few humble people get into fights. You hardly ever see two people that are very humble. I'm humble, you're humble. The Bible says about husbands and wives, it says, submit yourselves one to another in the fear of the Lord. People in a marriage that submit themselves to each other have very little squabbles and fights, because one of the two is usually always at a place where they're willing to forgive or move on or not make a big issue out of it. Amen. Say. But a person full of pride is going to be contentious. But with the well-advised, there's what? And here's the well-advised today. God hates pride. Can't stand it. You're not smart to be full of yourself. You're not all that. Can you say, I'm not all that? Say that with me. I'm not all that. Say it again with me. I'm not all that. One of the smartest things you'll ever say. I'm not all that. Doesn't mean you're a piece of dirt. No, but it certainly doesn't mean you're everything. Amen. Say. That's wisdom right there. Getting some wisdom this morning. Here's a verse that many of us could probably quote. Pride goes before what? And a haughty spirit before a what? Fall. How many knew that verse before I said it? Amen. Grandma might have even told it to you. Granddaddy might have even told it to you. Things that you ain't even heard maybe in a long time. It's there in your head. Somebody told you. Right from the Bible. When pride comes, say it with me, then comes what? Shame. Nothing worse than somebody so full of themselves, thinking they're all that, and they fall. And how great is that fall? It is a royal splat. The humble person, when he falls, at least he didn't fall that far. Amen. Did I lose you? But generally, the humble with the lowly, there's what? Some of the best people, smartest people, don't have the big education, are people that are country folk. Simple. People want to make fun of them. I hate to tell you, that's most of America. I hate to tell you that. Most of America, the average church in America is 75 or less on a Sunday morning in this country. And most people in this country, they don't have a ton of money, a ton of education. They get up and they work hard. They drive the trucks. They plant the beans. They do the things that need to be done to make this country go. Y'all know that, don't you? Yes or no? They don't get the accolades and don't want them. And I'd say a bunch of people like I'm describing got up this morning, or they're right now at church in America. Did you hear me or not? That's what I believe. God likes what? A man's pride shall bring him low, but honor shall uphold the who? Humble in their spirit. Amen. I love this stuff. Did you learn that first one or not? Is there any room for pride with the Lord? None. Zip. He hates it. Couldn't be stronger on that. Yes or no? Amen. So smartness is humility, being selfless. That's our attitude. Dumbness. And I could have said other words that would have been nice right there, but I didn't. Dumbness is being full of yourself. Proud. God's not going to put up with it. You can be that way to the day you die, but you're not going to be a person that had a close relationship with the Lord. You're just smoking yourself and fooling yourself. And there's a lot of people fooling themselves. But I'll put God's word against any of them people any day. Amen? Let's learn another one. Something that God likes. Well, God really likes our good words. Don't you want to be known as a person? When that person tells you something, if you're this person, don't you want to be the kind of person that people can count on your word? Yes or no? You think God likes it when we lying like a dog? Say, I love Jesus, but I'm lying like a dog. God says, no, I'm going to tell you something. I hate your lying tongue. This is God's word. This ain't me.
I can't believe you're saying God hates. Well, I'm sorry. Read the Bible. Turn off your news. You'll see it the way it is. Instead of a creation of God in your imagination, God gave his son for us. He loves us. He knows our wicked hearts. He knows what we're like. He has a better life for us. It's called his way, not our way. Amen. He made us. So, he hates a lying tongue. Can I take a poll? Be careful with answering the question. How many you love being lied to by someone? You love being lied to like a dog. Can I see how many hands love being lied to? Can I see some hands? I'm a smart audience. But it's funny, but it's okay to lie. It's funny, we don't like it though, do we? How much must God not like it? If we being evil and sinners don't like it, a holy God, no, he's cool with us lying like a dog. He hates that, guys, and that affects our, that's the second thing, is our word. So God hates a lying tongue. Here's smartness. Say it with me. Honesty. Be honest. Yeah, but if I be honest, they're going to know the truth. That's the whole point. The truth will set you free, Jack. Here's dumbness. Lying like a dog. I can't say lying without saying like a dog. You know what I'm saying? I love that. Lying like a dog. And generally, dogs don't lie. They lie around. Amen. But the point is that where'd that come from? Lying like a dog. Anyway, but listen, let's read the Bible. Proverbs, the lip of truth shall be established forever. It's amazing. When you tell something that's true, it's true forever. Right? Say, you told somebody the truth, you don't have to get up now. Uh-oh, I got to go fix it because yesterday I lied like a dog and I got to go fix it. No, when you tell the truth, you sleep at night. Now, there might be consequences with truth sometimes, but I'd rather be a person of truth. Amen? The lip of truth shall be established forever, but a lying tongue is before what? Isn't that the truth? Let's take another poll. Come on. This is fun. I got to have fun at church, too. How many of you lied and your tail got caught? Let me see some hands. Woo, I lied. I done got caught. How many it won't long before you got caught? You're like, whoop. It's funny. I'm raising youngins again, little kids again. They lie to me, to my face. Don't they, Kim? You hate to say it, don't you? About your own children. I know. But the point is, like, what am I, an idiot? And especially, they stay with that old lie, too. They think that old lie, if I say it, he going to believe it. It's just getting worse and worse and worse. Ain't it? Yes or no? Come on. Lying lips. Here's that word again. Here's that word you don't want put next to. It's not. Here it is. Lying lips are a what? It is not a good thing if abomination shows up next to something you're doing. To the Lord, but they that deal truly are the Lord's what? Isn't this good? I'm having a good time, y'all. Good. A froward man sows strife. A froward man. You can feel that right in there, a dishonest man. A whisperer. Somebody's telling false statements about other people. Spreading lies. Separates chief what? Let's do another quick poll. How many had somebody say something about you and somebody else, and it caused a problem between you and the person they said it's happening? You know, you understand what I'm saying? Somebody lied about you, it got back to somebody else, and it hurt that relationship. Can I see your hands? Isn't this a problem? Yes or no? Sure it is. God says, I hate that. Quit it. It's funny how we want to be salt and light to our world, but we don't want to do it this way. Amen? We think we can go out on visitation and send somebody a track or do a little good work for somebody. Listen, the best light you'll ever be is be an honest person. Be a humble, good person. And I tell you what, that still shines bright in our world because it's a dark world out there. Amen? So, God likes what? He likes honesty. The desire of a man is his kindness. And I love this. This is what I was talking about country folks a lot of times. A poor man is better than a what? A lot of poor people don't have the best education. A lot of poor people can't do this or that. They don't drive the fancy car. They don't have much at all. I'm talking about dirt poor people. But I tell you, God's word says, that poor man that loves me, that tells the truth, that's a good man or a good woman, I'm gonna tell you, raises his kids right, I'm going to tell you right now, God says, this man is better any day of the week than a lion, fill in the blank, whatever. Amen, say. Come on, this is smartness today. How many feeling smarter already? Yay! Come on! Here we go. My touch. These are things that really matter to God. So what have we learned so far? My attitude matters. My words matter. And guess what? My what matters? My touch. Now again, these are my words, the touch part. These are my words. I'm trying to make it understand, help you understand. Hands that shed innocent blood. God hates a proud look, a lying tongue, and hands that shed innocent blood. This is what his word says. So smartness is this. Have what kind of hands? Gentle hands. I don't mean to be ugly, but fellas, ladies like gentle hands too. Did you hear me? Say. We use our hands, we take our hands, especially in marriage, and we take our hands and we hurt that one supposedly we love and we marry to. You are a fool, you're an idiot. You hear me? And God is going to absolutely, he's coming after your tail right now. You hear me say? No mercy. Got it? Yes or no? God doesn't put up with this. He says, I want you to have gentle hands. Our hands are not meant to hurt one another. Yes or no? You're dumb if you have hands that want to hit people and strike out at people. That's dumbness. Amen. Hands that shed innocent blood. So what's dumbness? Violent hands. Say that with me. What's dumbness? Violent hands, that's dumb. Well, I'm strong, man. I'll whoop your tail. All you telling me is you probably cutting anyway. But the bottom line is you're telling me how dumb you are. Do you hear me or not? You're going to be violent? That's you? You're all that? And we got a whole culture right now. Our schools, our middle schools, our high schools, our streets, the gangs, the this, the that. Our country's full of the dumbest people on the planet thinking they're all that. This is how I'm going to do, man. Pathetic. Y'all hear me or not? It's not smart, guys. Proverbs 1:11, if they say, come with us, let us lay wait for blood. Come on, you be part of us, man. We'll lurk privately for the innocent. When they gone, we go take their stuff, man. Idiot. You hear me or not? You didn't know God's word was so plain, Jane, straight up, did you? Good for me. Good for me. This changed my life. This changed Gary's life. I grew up in a bad place. I grew up in Rockingham. Chuck, you've been on my street, ain't you, Bubba? Did it look like a happy street? Now, you could stand in my backyard where my own mother was shot and killed. And little did I know, over the years, I never thought about it. This woman to the left shot her husband. This woman across the fence, throat cut, stabbed 22 times, and her throat was cut right here. Boom, over here, go behind that house in Jimmy Kelly's basement. A man was down there one night, blew his brains out. And look at me now. Did God ever save Gary? Amen. Come on. This is the truth. This is the truth of the living God right here. Gentle hands. High school, a kid hit me. Eighth grade on the bus before I became a Christian. He hit me in my face on the bus. I beat the crap out of that kid. That was it, man. Beat his teeth right into his jaws. I'm all that, ain't I? I got saved. I wasn't changed that much. But a kid slapped me in front of everybody. We were running rough house. You know how you rough house with guys? You run, guys. You know how you rough house and play hard? And you're kicking each other. You're running, tripping, and just doing crap like that. You know what I'm saying? Excuse my language. You understand where I'm coming from? And one time I did it to him, and he fell hard. He did it to me, and it was okay. He got up in front of everybody and just slapped me so hard that I had fingerprints on my face for a while.
because he was a big kid. And little did I know, God was already starting to change my heart through his word. And it might not be a big deal to you, but I got up. I did not slap him back. I did not hit him in the face. I did walk up to him and say, if you ever do that to me again, I'll kill you. So I wasn't totally grown in the Lord, okay? Growth is little by little, okay? But the fact of the matter is, this is God's way. This is God's. Did y'all hear me today? No place for this. No place for Kim and I. This ain't happening in our house. Yes, ma'am, baby doll? Not happening. It's you and me, baby, all the way. Got it? Us against everybody. Got it, girl? Say, you and me. No violent hands at the Clark house. Yes or no? Amen. Say. That's wisdom from the Lord. You hear me? How many would be honest? I wish I'd have heard this when I was younger. It took me a while. I wish I'd have heard it. Amen. Good, though, ain't it? I'm proud of you. You know that. I love you, right? Moreover, you should take no satisfaction for the life of a murderer. This is God's word, which is guilty of death, but he shall surely be put to death. This is how God feels about people that kill people. Oh, God would never be that way. God's totally this way. He hates people that hurt people. He doesn't hate their heart. No, but he hates their actions and what they do. And that's his word. Whether you have been taught that in church or not, as you can see, it's right on the screen. Yes or no? Yes or no? Is this Gary talk? Yes or no? Right from the word. God likes what kind of hands? Gentle hands. Can I take a quick poll? How many in this room also like gentle hands? Can we just see some of God's creation? Give me your opinion. Do you like gentle hands or being slapped upside the face? Can I see some more hands? You like some gentle? Do you see how that God likes? We like what he likes. Get back to what he likes, man. This is smart. Look at this one. The fruit of the Spirit is, look at this. Love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. All inside of all that is gentle hands. Amen? Keep looking. What God likes. We got to quit. Oh, so long messages. My thoughts. So we saw the other things God hates. A heart that devises wicked imaginations. So here's smartness. My thoughts. God likes this. Listen to me. Thoughts or plans for good. Thoughts for plans of good or clean thoughts, not evil thoughts to hurt people, devising evil ways. God wants good thoughts in our minds. That's what God loves. What's dumbness? Wicked thoughts. Wicked thoughts. Thoughts or plans for evil or dirty thoughts. Amen? I don't want to say much right there. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. But thoughts or plans for evil, God is not, God hates that. God wants you to use your mind for good. Yes or no? Say that. God wants me to use my mind for good. Say it with me. God wants me to use my mind for good. There's so much good that needs to be done in our world and in our families. Yes or no? Come on, in our town. Use your mind for good. This is smart, guys. The thoughts of the wicked, here's that word again. There's that bad word. It's a what? A what? It doesn't take a scientist to figure this stuff out. But the words of the pure are what to the Lord? They're pleasant words. Amen. Come on. So, we're moving it. So God likes good thoughts. Finally, brethren, one of my favorite verses. Say it with me. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. God is not happy with us when we hear something about somebody, something that's not right, or whatever. We should not be entertaining that. That's not healthy. It's not good. It's just not a way to live life. God says, I don't like that. Think good thoughts. Yes or no? Amen. If you got to confess this, guys. You got to constantly catch yourself and say, this isn't right. This isn't God's will. I got to help. This isn't good for me. Amen. So keep looking. Woo, my walk. So we've looked at several. Here's another one. Feet that be swift running to what? Mischief. So my walk, my words is the word walk. That means our life, the way we're living life, the way we're walking the walk. Smartness is a peacemaker. Peacemaker, people that seek to do the right thing. You'll be surprised that when you're a person that wants just to do the right thing, how much less trouble you find yourself in. Amen. Keep looking. Dumbness is this. Troublemakers. You know who gets in the most trouble? Take a wild guess. Troublemakers. I'm not saying sometimes people do the right thing and get blamed. I get that. But boy, that is so far the exception than the rule. Generally, people in trouble are troublemakers. Okay? They seek to do damage. I can't believe I got put in jail. You broke into somebody's house, fool! What is wrong with you? Do you understand what I'm saying? Troublemakers generally get in trouble. That's not smart. You're seeking to do damage. Don't be envious against evil men, the Bible says. Don't desire to be with folks like that, troublemakers. Yeah, but they got all the women. Yeah, but they got some other mess coming too. They probably got little babies, and they're going to have lots of child support, and they're going to have lots of jail time, and they're going to have lots of mess. Come on. Don't desire to be with them, for their heart studies destruction, and their lips talk about things they fixing to do wrong. They're making plans for wrong. God's word says, not that you better, you're smarter. You're smarter than that. God says, you're my child. You're not better than anybody, but you are smarter. That's what I want to teach my kids, even the young ones we're doing right now. My kids think they have the smartest daddy in the whole world. You know why? Because I tell them. They also think I'm really good looking. Because I what? The point is, I want them to know that when daddy's telling them something, that's a smart man right there. I'm telling them something that's true. I want them to look up to me, not that I'm some great, look at me, I'm full of, no. But I want you to know when you're hearing me, daddy's not going to tell you some mess. It's going to be the right way. That's a smart man right here. Amen. I don't know how you do your kids, but I don't want them to have no doubt. This is the way. Walk in it. Amen. You cool? God likes peacemakers. By mercy and truth, iniquity's purged, and by fear of the Lord, men depart from evil. Good stuff, man. When a man's ways please the Lord, he makes even his what? I wasn't going to tell you this, and I got to quit almost. Are y'all okay? There's no ball game or anything. Remember my story last week getting cussed out? That hadn't happened to me much in my life. Hadn't happened recently at all until last week. Again, wisdom up there came through into me, thank God. And I didn't respond like a human wants to respond. But I told him, I'm still going to be kind to you. And all week it was tough. Because I bought a little place and somebody's right there. I get that. And it was tough. But I still did right. And I said, whenever I see him, I'm going to call him by name and say, hey! And so sure enough, I finally saw him this week. And sure enough, I got out of my truck and I said, hey! And he looked at me, head down, and did his hand like this. And I walked over to him. He said, I'm sorry. I was wrong.
And I thought, he probably ain't never said that. I stuck my hand out, not because I'm a great guy, because I'm smart. Not because of me, but because of him. Amen. And I took my hand out and said, that's okay. I forgive you. No problem. I said, I like chewing the fat with you, man. I like that. I like being able to talk with you. That's what I miss. I apologize some more. It's all good. It's all good. No problem. I'm not bragging. I'm just trying to say, this is God's plan for our life. Y'all hear me or not? And if you know who I'm talking about back there, you hear me? Keep your mouth shut. Amen? Yes or no? Amen. Did you hear me? Yes or no? Amen. You with me? You in church? You don't get struck by lightning. Amen or oh me? Amen. Come on. Come on. Just trying to make a point. My actions, a false witness that speaks lies. A little bit more on that lying thing. But this has to do with my actions. Smartness is this, being real, a person of integrity. God loves you being real, a person of integrity. A person of integrity, the word integrity means that you have all the pieces together. You're not perfect, but your life's not a wreck falling apart. You're not always having to put it back together because you're lying like a dog and you're just living life by the fly. And you don't have integrity. Is that delusion on that? Integrity, person of truth and doing these things, being real. See, when you have integrity, you can walk and you can be a normal person. And whatever you do is you. Doesn't mean you're smarter than people. It just means that's Gary or that's Debbie or that's Fred or that's, you know, that's Susie. And that's just who we are. Amen. Dumbness is being a phony. You don't have your act together. You're always having to pretend and put pieces in places, and it's not really real. It's being a hypocrite. God hates that. He wants us to be real. He loves you for you. Amen. Buy the truth. Look at this scripture. Buy, B-U-Y. Buy the truth and don't sell it. Don't sell truth. You buy it. Get as much truth as you can. Don't you give up truth. Sell it. Also, wisdom and instruction and get you some understanding. I love that scripture, don't you? God likes us being what? Real. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about your neck. Write them upon the tables of your heart. Amen. I love this. Raj, is this the last one? You're killing me. My heart. He that sows discord among the brethren. My word, heart. You can come to church. You can act the part. But if you're a Christian, quote, that goes around sowing discord among the brethren, God hates what you're doing. Amen? How many have been in churches like that and it absolutely killed the church? Let me see your hand. Yes or no? Amen? How many have been in more than one like that? Let me see your hand. See, that's what's sad. Guys, we don't tolerate that here. There's a lot of people that hurt that come in these doors. They don't need to have us talking about them like a dog. They need to have us loving each other and caring. You got it or not? Say, come on, that's horrible. He that sows discord among the brethren. God says, I hate that. I hate that when you do that. Doesn't hate you. So smartness is being a person of unity. Being what? You are not a kind person if you talk about other people. You can say, I'm kind. You unkind. Dumbness is this. Somebody that sows discord and a gossip. And if you're a gossip, I'm telling you, you ought to get down on your face in the dirt somewhere this week, and you ought to just nail it and say, God, I just repent of this. I'm sorry. I am dumb. Don't make excuses. I'm dumb. And I want to get up smart. Amen? And God help. How many ever had to turn from stuff in your life before? There was sin in your life, and you had to turn from it. Can I see some hands? Nine of you. But anyway, I got all my hands up. Anyway, my point is, it's okay to get smart. This ain't a list that you check off today feeling, I'm smart. These are things that often we'll have to catch ourselves on and get humble. Amen. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this. Say it with me. Thou shalt love thy what? As yourself, guys. Come on. But if you bite, if you devour one another, take heed that you're not what? What?
My lunch got ate too. Yep. Not good. Amen. God likes what? Say it loud. God likes what? Had a guy this week, friend of mine, helped start another church, came out of our church, helped start another church. Not because he was angry with us, but because he felt it was the will of God. And I got behind him. Amen? Beautiful. Good situation. I didn't like it because I loved him so much. But I was proud of him. Amen? And so he and I talked some. He came by to see me this week. And we just, in my yard, hanging out by his truck. And I told him, because he loves us and what we're doing here, the debt free. And so I told him how we did this week, you know. And I could see it in his face. I felt it. He said, that's because all of y'all are together. All of y'all are, you know, you're going the same direction. People believe in what you're doing. You hear me or not? What was he saying? Your church has what? Unity. And sometimes when people say something, you can hear something in what they didn't say. We have a special thing here. Did you hear me or not? Yes or no? It's worth fighting for. Unity is worth fighting for. How many would say that in your family? I've had to do that in my family to make sure these youngins and what have you. I fought for it. It was worth us keeping our family together. Anybody like that knows what I'm talking about? Well, that's how church is too. Amen. Yes or no? This is special to us on Sunday. I don't have enemies in this church when I preach. Did you know that? I love every one of you. And I think you love me. That's how crazy I am. I love you, John. Do you love me? See there, I told you. Amen. Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell in unity. And we got to quit because we got communion. Like what God likes. Raj, say that was the last one. What really matters. We're done with this list. I don't care how you're laughing. Smartness. Say it with me. Smartness is what? Here it is. Say it with me. Say it with me on the side. On the side. Here's smartness. Here we go. Here we go. Smartness. Say it out loud. Humility. Dumbness is what? Pride. Smartness is honesty. Dumbness is lying like a dog. Gentle hands is smartness. Violent hands is dumbness. Good thoughts is smartness. Wicked thoughts, dumbness. Peacemaker, smartness. Troublemaker, dumbness. Being real, smartness. Being a phony, dumbness. Unity, smartness. Discord, dumbness. Let's thank the Lord for his word. We're done. Amen. Woo! Come on, let's stand up. We have communion. We're late. I have got to run. Here we go. Come on, come on. It was important, though. We needed to hear God's word. Come on. Are y'all okay? I'm just glad it wasn't like the middle of September when football was in. I'm horrible. I'm still sort of dumb, amen? I ain't got it all together, but don't tell my children. Come on, let's pray together. Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for helping us with your word today. Lord, thank you for changing my life, helping me as a young man, saving me and my drunk mama. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that mom's now forever with you in heaven. She's safe. No one's hurting her anymore. Because you are a great God. And Lord, thank you for directing my steps all these years. And Lord, thank you for forgiving me and the steps that I took that were my own and not yours. Lord, thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord, that you can take us no matter where we came from, no matter who we are. You can save us. And the Comforter, Lord, Holy Spirit of the living God, you come alongside of us. And through your word, we can grow, we can change, our heads can be different, our life can be different. Lord, thank you for your word. Thank you for never leaving us. Thank you for not erasing our name out of the Lamb's Book of Life when we miss the mark. Thank you for being faithful and patient with us. Lord, I pray all of us today will just grab a hold of this message and say, God, I want to be smart. I want to be smart like you want me to be. Oh, God, bless your word to our heart in Jesus' name. And with heads bowed this morning, the smartest decision you'll ever make is to believe God's word And guys, it starts with believing that God loves you and gave his son Jesus for you, that he died on the cross for you, that he rose from the dead for you. And the smart thing would to do would be to reject anything that says you're going to get to heaven any other way than Jesus. That's the smartest thing you'll ever do, is not go to hell. Don't be so dumb that you're going to go to hell because you believe all religions are the same, all roads are the same, being good will get you there. I'm telling you right now, the dumbest decision you will ever make in your life is to not put your faith in Jesus Christ. That is the dumbest decision you'll ever make. And if you don't like hearing the word dumb that much, I'm sorry. But it's the dumbest decision you will ever make. The worst dumbness on the planet is having God give his son for you and you say no to his son. Would you say yes today? Would you do point number one on that screen and humble yourself, not be full of yourself, but be selfless today? Would you lay down before the feet of the Lord today and say, Lord, I come to you as a sinner, and I want you to save me. If you're ready, and what do I mean ready? You'll have to do it sincerely. You'll have to do it humbly. You'll have to mean it and be real. Phoniness ain't gonna fly. And I'd like to lead you in that prayer. Would you pray with me? Would you this morning? Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, I know I am a sinner. I ask you to forgive me of my sins. I am not good enough in my own strength. Anything I can do, Lord, nothing that I can do in my own life can get me to heaven. Nothing. I absolutely confess that to you. And Lord, I'm telling you, in my heart, I want to do the smartest thing ever. And I'm doing it now. I believe in your son, Jesus. Jesus, I want you to know I believe in you. I believe you are God's only son. I believe you died on the cross for me. I believe you rose from the dead for me. I wasn't there, Lord, when it happened. I know that. But by faith of my own free will, I'm reaching out to you in faith. I'm putting my belief in you, Lord, not in myself, not in some preacher. Nothing like that, Lord. I'm putting my faith in Jesus. Save me today, I pray. Save me today, I pray. You said you would. And here I am. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. With heads bowed, how many would say, Pastor Gary, I did the smart thing today. I accepted the Lord today. Can I see your hand? I did that, preacher. Boy, I'm certainly not ashamed of it. Buddy, ma'am, several of you. Ma'am, God bless you today. Amen. Father, thank you for this time we had. Thank you for letting me have fun in church. But Lord, also help us now as we go have communion. And Lord, I'm still happy and it's fun to be able to go out with the children of the living God and have communion and celebrate Jesus. Oh God, what a delight it is. So help us as we go. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, come on. Let's go have communion. We want all of you, if you're a believer in Christ. Let's go. Come on.